finish, guys. We got a lot of stuff to come to this one. All right, here we go. Okay, guys, we call this a head inside single chase ankle. It's option number two. All right? To do this against a stud, guys, you got to do five things right. All right? The first thing I got to do right, guys, length of shot. I have to freaking be able to be. Got to be elbow deep. Number one, I hit this shot. I have to be elbow deep right here. My lock cannot be here or here. No space. Number one, I'm elbow deep right here. Number two, guys. Mario's going to sprawl. You know why he's going to sprawl, guys? Because that's what the freaking stud does. The stud sprawls. So when he goes to sprawl, guys, as soon as my hands locks, I know he's going to sprawl. When he goes to sprawl, guys, I lock my hand. Watch what my right elbow does, guys. I'm going to try to take my right elbow, and I'm going to try to put it right where my right knee's at. Right to the mat. All right. Also, you're going to notice my right shoulder is going low. This step is crucial. One, elbow deep. Two, he's sprawling. Look what I'm doing. I'm pulling in and down, trying to get my right elbow right there beside my knee. What's going to happen is Mario's going to go to both knees. But this knee, one I got, he's going to be right beside my knee. If his knee's back here, guys, I'm extended. He will beat me every time. So number one, elbow deep. Two, he sprawls. I pull him down right there. Look where his knee's at. Three, I come off my knee. I get all the way right there to my right elbow. Notice how low my right shoulder is to my left. I never hit my left elbow. Hands are locked. Right hip, lower than left. Right butt cheek, lower than left. It'll stay that way throughout the whole move. Number four, I circle. Right hip stays lower. I put my right knee right behind the elbow. My right hip is still low. My right knee is touching my right elbow. Number five, guys, I unlock my hands. My outside hand stays above the knee, and then I change level, keep fighting my shoulder behind. We call it a head inside, chase the ankle. We don't chase the ankle as much anymore as we chase that far. And notice, my right arm stays under his butt, and I drop. Again, one, elbow deep, two, pulling down, three, keep the right elbow, right hips lower. Four, step over, five, change levels, both hands stay above the knee, and I drop. Hey guys, I've been showing this move for probably 25 years of my life, 27 years of my life. You know what I found, guys, show this move? Most people, they screw up the offense. They either screw up one, they screw up three, or they screw up five. Hey guys, I don't care how good your setup is. I don't care how good your shot is. If I don't lock, double deep, here's what I see all the time. I will see this, guys, tomorrow night. I'm over here for live wrestling. Watch. I'm going to see you guys see a great setup, great shot, and all of a sudden you lock here where there's space. And here's what's going to happen. I'm still going to pull his knee down beside my knee, but I want you to notice my position. Look at my position. Mario sprawls. I pull him down. All the weight just shifted to my head, left shoulder, and left knee. There, Mario's just going to bump me in, bump into me, and he's going to beat me. All because, guys, I didn't wrap up with you. The dumbest one, guys, is screw up. It's number five. A lot of junior high guys do this, even high school guys do. They did everything right. They get all the way to right here. They step over, and all of a sudden they do this. They start driving up. I come up around the waist, what becomes effective is a wizard, he's going to wizard me down, now I got to fight his front head on. Always, instead of your death bar, can't wizard in that position. The hardest one, guys, that we got to spend a little time on is number three. Number three, guys, I say once you get that elbow down, see his right elbow down, this elbow never hits, this knee never touches. Notice, guys, Mario's got all the way on his right elbow, right hip has to be lower than his left. If he's ever on both knees, I can beat him. Why? I hate this move, a front quarter. Here, we come in front quarter. I can do a niter, it's one of our big penny moves we're going to go through tomorrow. Or I can just tap my way down and beat him that way. I cannot do any of that if Mario's right here. Can't front quarter, can't knock him down. Can you guys see that? All with that right hip. All right, there Mario steps over and he chases him. Hey, one more thing on this, guys. All right, I get in all kinds of arguments. I have all kinds of college coaches come in and say, Coach, I want to see your head inside single. You know, I showed my head inside single. I did it a month ago. Lehigh's coach came in. Coach, I want to see your head inside single. All right? Anyway, here's what a lot of college coaches show. Now, I'm not saying I'm right and they're wrong. If I'm convinced I'm right, I'm convinced they're wrong. All right, here's what I'm talking about. Once he steps over, college coaches show this. They say, take your outside hand. They say, drop down the shoelace. Then they say this magical words. They say, shove. There he pulls up the shelf. There he chases it right there. All right. Looks good. Looks pretty. But you know what, guys? I'm just going to tell you this. David Taylor was in. You guys all know David Taylor. I coached him in high school. Coach pushing since he's been 10 years old. David Taylor's in my high school room. What was it, 3 years ago? 3 years ago, Russ saw my son, Bo, for Christmas. He comes up to me and says, Coach, I can't get my head inside singles. What do you mean you can't show head inside singles? And he goes, Coach, I don't know. I just can't get it anymore. I go, well, it's got to be one of three things. So it's got to be your setup, it's got to be your shot, or it's got to be your finish. It can only be one of those three, I promise. I'm watching drill with my son, Bo. Oh, they're drilling. It looks freaking slick. David Taylor's a bad, bad dude, fellas. Every time he hit a head inside singles, guys, he'd take his left hand, drop it in, he'd shelf it. There, he'd chase. Oh, it looks slick. There's David Taylor drilling out. He's shelving, baby. All right? And you know what, guys? I said, Taylor, what are you doing? I said, maybe he comes. I said, why are you shelving? Why are you taking your right hand down? Shoelace, lift him up. I'm a coach. I've been drilling that way. I don't know. I go, David, guys, you understand something? If Mario takes this left hand and takes it down here, it opens up a couple more things I can beat him with. Number one, I can shove his head down. I can park him on 169.4. That's what my fat butt weighed this morning, up on top of his back. Hold it for the ball game. Here, guys, I'm scoring. But the big ones, guys, college guys, and the training. And long way. David goes close. That's exactly what guys are doing. They're highlighting over. They're rocking my crotch. And I get this right here. Guys, here's what I tell all my guys. Mario's right here. Great position. When he unlocks his hands, that left hand stays there, guys. He keeps my hip locked out. I can't get difficult on top of his back. Can you guys see that? There is no way I can high leg all the way over. Do you see that? Now he reaches across, chases it, right together. Hey, guys, I was just bragging about my stud, Alex Marinelli. Alex Marinelli's a bad dude. Went undefeated last year. Beat the number one ranked guy in the country named Mason Manley, the wearer cap, in the finals of the Ironman tournament. Went undefeated, won his third state title. The last time he got beat was 2 years ago. He lost to a guy from St. Ed's. He got beat 11-10. He got the first period, he got beat, or he was losing 6-2. He got taken down 3 straight times off his head inside single. Marinelli does this, comes out, first 5 seconds of the match against St. Ed's at Grand High School. Luckily, we beat him. We tied 29-29. We beat him on criteria. Marinelli does this to Marcus Scheidel. Hits a great head inside single. And guys, I'm telling you, sometimes little things determine whether you get this or you get this. Marinelli hit a head inside single. Look at Mario's lock. Where's that? It's on the mat. So he did the shot on Scheidel. First 5 seconds, 10 seconds of the match, Scheidel does this. Shuts his head down. See how my knee beat is locked there? Scheidel starts to run right up, press over, grab Marinelli's heel, ankle. 2-0. Scheidel, Bull gets mad. That's his nickname, Bull. Bull stands up, cuts, comes back, gets another head inside single. Left is locked right there on the mat. Scheidel does this. 4-1. Marinelli gets away. Third time, guys, after I go out and punch Marinelli. Gets the other head inside single. Beats a lock. Spins around. It's up 6-2 on Marinelli. Marinelli come back and beat the other 10. Guys, you know what Marinelli did wrong? I tell all my guys, one more thing. You get the shot, guys. Look at my last one. I'm going to stay on the mat. I do this right here. I just call it the hand curl. And when you hand curl, guys, you're going to lock this whole leg up right here. So, all my guys, you go see Marinelli single leg now. Every time he hits a head inside single, guys, he's got his hand curl right there. Got my hip locked out. I can't beat that lock. Then when you unlock, stays locked out the hip. Then you chase it. Little things, guys, can determine whether you get to or give up to. One more time, I'll try. Number one, elbow deep. Here, 2, pull in and down. 3, as I go to my elbow, look at this big curl I'm doing. 4, step over. 5, unlock. Stay above both knees under his butt. And drop. Love it, guys. Head inside singles, chase single. Partner, do me a favor. Don't sprawl until he gets his hands locked. When you sprawl, go to both knees. Also, partner, don't get a close wizard. I'm going to go to that in a minute. I'll beat that. We got it. Let's go. Hey, one more quick thing. Then I want to start to drill these really fast. Hey, guys, make sure you step over. Once I step over that leg, and my knee comes right behind my elbow, I really want you guys to do this. I want you guys to change level. Look at this level change, guys. My right shoulder, look what's going to do. When I change level, my right butt cheek comes down on the heel. My right shoulder just keeps fighting behind the leg. The reason why, guys, I even sometimes go all the way to my body. My brother, Russell, a guy named John Smith. You guys ever heard of John Smith, guys? He's the head coach at where? Oklahoma State. He's a 2-time national champ, 2-time Olympic champ, 4-time world champ. One of the most decorated American wrestlers ever. All right. Anyway, my brother, Russell, John Smith, 3 times in college. My brother was a bad dude. He was a second four-time state champ in Ohio. All right, he was a two-time national champ at the University of Wisconsin. Anyway, guys, he was ranked number one in the country. John Smith was ranked number two. First time he wrestled was at Las Vegas Open in the finals. My brother beat the crap out of him. 9-3, had him pinned. Second time he wrestled was at Oklahoma State. I don't know if any of you guys have ever been to Oklahoma State at a place called Gallagher Hall. But let me tell you what, guys, I hate that place. It's crazy. 10,000 drunk hillbilly cowboys root against you. All right? It's crazy out there. Anyway, my brother gets beat 1-0. He was in on 7 head inside singles from John Smith. Did not score on any of them. Here's what Smith did. My brother hit a head inside single, tore up the first period. Elbow down, stepped over. Smith stuck his hand back and just put my brother's arm in. The good Lord bless John Smith, unbelievable flexibility. John Smith did this. He stuck his right leg way out there, almost to splits at his left hand right here. My brother went to reach across, couldn't get the leg every time, guys. My brother went from the waist. Whole first period. Jimmy Jordan fought a front reference. Scored in 0-2. Second period, guys, he rides my brother out. You guys know in college you get riding time?
Yeah.
In the match, if I got one more minute of riding time than Mario, I get a point. So he rides my brother out, he's got 2 minutes of riding time. Crowd's going crazy. Why? Jim's ranked number one, Smith's ranked number two. Hometown boy, they're all rooting for John Smith. 10,000 crazy drunks. Next thing you know, guys, third period, John Smith goes down. My brother rides him for 1 minute and 1 second. So now Smith's got 59 seconds riding time, which is 0. Then my brother cuts him. So now both losing 1-0. Was he on 3 more head inside singles? Every time Smith stuck his leg up, my brother couldn't get it. My brother loses 1-0. Crowd goes crazy. My brother's crying like a baby. He's got John Smith in a month in the national tournament. We go back and watch the film. My brother says, Jeff, I can't take it down. My head inside singles, my best shot. I can get in. I can't score. Well, guys, here's the bottom line. You can't come from a place. We watch the film. Me and my brother start to drill this, guys. Every time we step over, if that guy stays that leg up, guys, watch what's going to happen. I'm going to change level, I'm going to go all the way up my chin, right here. And then, guys, the closest thing for me to grab, still be on his butt, is right here with me. My brother, Jimmy Jordan, beat John Smith 7-4 national finals. It says it's ranked the 14th greatest match in NCAA wrestling history. My brother took him down 3 times. All 3 takedowns, head inside, same, chase in. Here's what he done. Here, he stepped over, Smith stuck it like way out. My brother could not grab it, could not grab it. My brother did this. Finish it right through the butt. Here. Outside hand, still above the knee. I'm in great position. He can't get his head one more back. Why? Left hand's above the knee. Close strength to the grab and still be underneath his butt. It's right there. Wizard, Mario. Wizard, wizard. He can't. A lot of times, guys, probably 50% of the time, when my guys hit a head inside single, or 60%, when they step over, they penetrate the hip. Even the guys on his knees, they do this right here. They hit a head inside single. Here, they step over, they do this right here. Change left. I'm still in good position. What can Mario do? Nothing. And drop. Right now, let's just try 2 or 3 of these. I just want you to get the habit. Once you step over here, I pinch it right here, buddy. You can look how much farther you can reach. You can reach another 2.5.